This is a special presentation from the Brighton Central School District.
Friends and colleagues, welcome back to school. Please join me in welcoming Luca Albano, BHS senior, an incredible musician, joined today by his parents, Laura and Pierre as well. Luca, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Now that's a walk-off. That, Luca, that was just amazing. Thank you, and thank you again to Laura and Pierre for sharing your time with us this morning. There is no better way to start our year and think about our work with children and the nurturing and support of their talents than to start with such a talented human being in Luca, and we'll hear from Sofian later this morning as well. It's just a great reminder, I think, of what happens when talents are nurtured and supported the way you do it. So again, one more time, thank you to Luca. Once again, welcome back to all of you. Please join me in welcoming our Board of Education, Alumni Association Leader Mary Jane Link, and Sofian Syed, BHS Executive Council President. Wow, it's just really incredible. Each year it's great to see everyone, but to be in this space together, back together in person, is very special. And for those on Zoom, it is special to have you. We're glad that there's an alternative as well this year, and looking forward to seeing you as we interact personally over the next several days. I hope that you all had a great summer. We're so very happy to be back in this space, but also the gift of being here. So not just in this space in person, but being in Brighton together, the finest educators, the finest staff members, the most incredible people that you could ever have the opportunity to work with. I just find it to be such a gift to be in this space together and in this work together as colleagues. So I want to focus for a minute very much on you. Over the last 18 months, we have experienced something unprecedented, to say the least. I think it's there probably aren't great words that we haven't already heard on every retrospective about the last year and a half, but it certainly was somewhat unimaginable before this period of time. Never in a million years would I, or frankly probably anyone, have foreseen the experience that we've been through. Shut down schools for months, come back to school, but every other day, teach children as young as 5 years old virtually. We wouldn't have imagined these things. I would never have taken a bet that that could happen. And I'm a Sabres and Bills fan who takes the bet that they're gonna do well every year. So hopefully at least the Bills will salvage that. But here's a bet that I would have taken. If someone had said, you will face the strangest circumstances, and here's what it's gonna look like. Here's what a pandemic looks like, here's what you're gonna have to do in schools, this is how it will impact schools and kids and the community. And then they said, who would you bet on? Who would you bet on to be there for the community? Who would you bet on to support children as learners, but more importantly, as people experiencing every imaginable human challenge? Who would you bet on to care for each other, to put service above self, to innovate, to adapt, change, adjust, adjust again, reimagine, adjust again? I'd bet on you. Every time, twice on Sunday and every day after that, I'd bet on you. And I'd have won the bet over and over and over again because of what you did over the past 18 months. So before we dig into what's in front of us, I simply wanted to point out what you have already managed to do and how deeply grateful we are for you and your work, as colleagues, but even more so as parents and community members. So to our entire staff, for everything that you've done, here's to you. Thank you. I include in those thanks and those sentiments the members of our leadership team as well. Without question, they too have gone above and beyond. They've worked tirelessly to find answers to your questions, give you the support that you need, and lead without the benefit of time or clear parameters in many, many situations over and over again throughout last year. I would like to personally take a moment, though, to thank them for their work as well. They advocated on your behalf in every way they could, and again, like nobody took a methods class in teaching through a pandemic. There certainly was not a leadership class in policy making during a pandemic or decision making during such a period of time. So thanks very much to them for their work as well. So each year we marvel at the work that is done to prepare for our opening from an organizational and facilities perspective. I'd really like to ask you all to take a moment when you have a chance and thank those around us who do so much, often without it being noticed. In fact, the nature of the work of our buildings and grounds staff is it often is only noticed if it's not done or it can't be done, but there's so much that goes into the work that they do each and every day. And if you have a chance, if you could just stop for a moment and thank them. The way they keep our environment so clean, so sparkling, but so safe also for all of us. And certainly this past year has highlighted that in terms of the disinfection, the constant cleaning, the moving furniture here, there, everywhere, moving it again, here, there, everywhere, there and here and back again. Everything that they did to make this work, I can't tell you how much we appreciate it. They couldn't get things, right? So when you walk through the hallways and you see in any of the buildings where there's ceiling tiles that are not put back, know that that drives that staff absolutely bananas, but they can't get ceiling tiles. When you see things unpainted, like in the display cases out front, they can't get paint or painters. You can't get materials, you can't get supplies, and you can't get some of the people that are contractors that come in to do some of that work. And then, on top of that, everything that gets done by that staff gets undone when, through a capital project, people come back in, do additional work, and change the space that was just prepared for the school year, often without notice, without warning, and without accommodation. And they do an unbelievable job. I had the opportunity to walk through the buildings with John Novelli, Rob Luce, Lou Limo, the building principals and head custodians last week, and really get into the nitty-gritty about the work that was being done, each of the little projects that happens. And it's astounding when you sit back and reflect on the work that they do and how they prepare the space and take great pride in preparing that space for all of us. So could you join me in giving them a round of applause? There are other support services that deserve our thanks as well. Please join me in a heartfelt thanks to our clerical staff members throughout the district, business office staff, central office staff, data support, human resources, PPS office staff, technology, audio, visual, food service, transportation staff, whose work can be described again as to organize, support, reorganize, communicate again, redesign, do it again. I can't believe what they do. One of the gifts of being in this role is learning, after I left the classroom, all of the different pieces that people are responsible for that make it happen behind the scenes. And it's really amazing to think organizationally about all the work. We often think about teaching and learning, our primary mission and focus, all the time, right? That is the driver for what we do. But everything that goes into getting kids here, getting them home, doing it safely, getting you paid, making sure benefits are taken care of, right, that the entire organization is running. It's just incredible the work that is done. And again, often we don't recognize it happening because it happens so seamlessly behind the scenes. So can you join me in thanking all of them for their work as well? Very specifically, I'd like to thank Lisa Hartman, Christopher Schneider, Mike Lehner, Nicole Vandermeed, Eric Gruner, Dan Goldman, and of course, Kim Lanzafame for all of their help all of the time, but especially in preparation for today, making this welcoming and this opening very special. I'd like to thank our leadership team, Lou, Allison, and Deanna, our Board of Education, for their work throughout the summer and the year, their incredible support. I'm honored to be a part of this team and blessed in life to work with such great colleagues each and every day. You've heard it from me and will continue to hear it from everyone who works with you, but let's take a minute to hear it in the words of children.
Is awesome because
we have recess.
It's like the only school that really
where you can just be like yourself anytime.
I like that we get to learn new things every day.
They let us do Chef's Choice, and they let us do a bunch of new food. I've heard that some schools you have to wear a uniform, and at this school you can wear whatever you want.
Chef's Choice.
Yes.
My dad picked out my clothes today, so.
There's French toast sticks. There's everything. Probably even bananas.
It's just a really super school. The song tells the truth.
When you think back, it was really fun, and you liked it a lot.
The only thing I wanted to do in the summer was go back to school and learn at Council Rock.
The best thing about Council Rock is probably, I think, all the really nice teachers here.
First, they don't shout like the teachers at TCMS.
Teachers, they're so nice.
I really like my teachers because they're patient and fun.
Like, they treat you with respect, and you should treat them with respect, too.
Everybody is kind of just helpful, and they can help you when you need.
Sometimes they let you, I don't know, just have fun. And that's what school is all about.
And also, at the end of the year, we don't do math.
So the best thing about Council Rock is how all the teachers just stick with it and always die loud.
They are awesome and they do a lot of stuff to help the kids.
My teacher at Council Rock this year in second grade, she is very sweet, very polite, and very lovable.
I think the best thing about Council Rock is the friends. Because like when you're feeling blue or down, they might come ask you if they want to play with you.
I will remember my COVID teachers because this was a very hard year and it was a very good year.
Thank you, teachers!
You'll miss me, Counselor! Bye!
Bye!
Thanks for teaching us!
Friends is fun.
It's like a really united school and they have a lot of programs.
The community is really great. Like everyone is really supportive of one another.
I actually Googled what's the best school district in Monroe County and it is Brighton Central School District. So we got one of the best school districts in the country.
When you come to Friends, you need to know Friends is amazing. Don't worry about anything.
The lunchroom food is kind of questionable when it comes to grilled cheese and peanut butter and jelly because I add like a lot of peanut butter. But I mean, that's not always a bad thing.
And ice cream socials. You get ice cream. You come to school after, you get ice cream at school.
It's an awesome school. There's a lot of really nice teachers.
They're understanding and some of them give you candy and extra recess.
There's a lot of fun activities to do too, like field trips and recess is fun and all the specials are really great too.
Some of the things at Friends that I learned are to like not disclude people and be nice to everyone.
I learned my love for clarinet and every day I practice.
There is amazing teachers here and staff and everyone is awesome and respectful and kind.
Best thing about the teachers at Friends is probably how kind they are.
Some of them, I guess, I might not have thought I'd like, to be honest. But I have realized now that I might have had the wrong information from other kids' students.
I don't want this to sound rude, but they were like born in a different generation than like now. And I think that they might not like a lot of the things kids are doing now or what they go through, they don't exactly understand the most. Oh, that sounds so mean.
They make everything fun, like even math that seems boring.
It's just amazing what they can do in 3 short years, which is like 30 months maybe. Like that's incredible what these teachers have done for me.
They teach more than just math. They teach like unity and kindness.
Like they teach to each student's level and give each student what they need.
They put the learning into fun instead of like when you get something wrong and they say like, oh well then, you failed.
I like that no matter how weird you are, they still accept you.
They all were able to like let loose and have fun, but also push you to the point where you had to work hard to either get what you wanted or do like good on something.
Even though it's like through a pandemic, like I've learned so much and I've worked even harder than I ever have before.
For the teachers, so it's probably a lot going from 10
10 students, 24 students.
Like, it's amazing how all these teachers are coping.
Switching from hybrid and all this other stuff and all this other stuff and blah, 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 blah. So, yeah.
But I feel like everyone has done their best to help others and been very supportive, pushed me so much to be my best.
Keep doing what you're doing because, if you were to see a chart of how much I've learned in the past couple of years, this is, like, off the chart this year.
I would say that's 100% true.
So, teachers, I would really like to say thank you for teaching me all of the stuff you taught me.
Thanks, teachers.
Thank you for giving me the best 3 years of school, of my third, fourth, and fifth grade. I hope I was actually considering failing fifth grade just so I could redo it again.
So I would just give a big thank you to every staff, teacher, and anybody who works in the school.
Goodbye, French Row!
Hello, TCMS!
Every single teacher has helped me so much, so thank you guys all.
And that's really it. Thank you.
I just want you to know it's like a very safe community, and be who you are and don't be afraid to shine.
We love friends!
I miss you guys so much.
Twelve Corners. Well, starts off pretty good, and for teachers, it just progressively gets better.
I like 12 Corners because we have a lot of freedom in what we do in class, I think. The teachers listen to what we like to do and what we don't like to do to make classroom fun.
Like, layout doesn't make a lot of sense, but if you walk around and you like ask people where to go, then it makes a lot more sense.
I think it's fun, and I think you get a lot of opportunities.
Great sports system, great teachers, and like the lunches are pretty great.
As a new student, I felt really welcomed, and they provided me with a lot of information and help.
I only just transferred here for 8th grade, but it's been really nice so far. The teachers have been really welcoming.
School during COVID has been different than all the other years, because I think both teachers and students were adjusting the ways that we're learning.
Teachers didn't really get recognized for all the stuff they had to do, like their lesson plans, and everything had to just get totally switched.
For me personally, I liked the school year because I didn't like going to school every day.
I think the teachers at 12 Corners are very good because they're all very nice and they're very good at explaining things.
They want to make sure that everyone understands what they're learning.
They care about your progress and what you're doing and the work and where you are.
It really feels like they actually care and they're not just trying to get you to like pass the test. They actually care that you're having fun and learning.
Thank you to everyone who works in the building.
Staff.
You guys are awesome!
Thanks everyone! We're going to high school!
Thank you for everything.
We passed 8th grade.
Have fun and I don't know, enjoy getting back to being a little bit more normal with everyone.
It's not a coronavirus year anymore! Yeah, or let's hope it's not. Hopefully we'll be full time and you'll be back to your normal routine and everyone will be happy. Yeah. That's what I think.
Thanks, teachers.
So, I've had a lot of great teachers over my years at Brighton High School. I can't say I've had anybody that I've even disliked in the slightest.
Something I noticed about the teachers is that they're incredibly dedicated, especially when I send like emails, like at like 1 a.m., they usually respond, and that makes stress a little bit better. And in general, they've been really good and kind to me.
All the teachers here at Brighton High School, they're great. They help you out a lot, and they've helped me grow.
All the teachers here at Brighton High School are just so amazing at helping kids develop into the best versions of themselves.
Especially during this crazy year, they really have gone above and beyond to do everything they could to make this a special year for us seniors.
Even though students sometimes neglect the efforts that our teachers put into us.
They've always been very helpful, and I'm thankful that I've
been able to be here at Brighton.
Every single one of the teachers that I've had has been so helpful and has been so welcoming and never makes me feel bad for like asking for extra help.
I mean, I've definitely had teachers I've liked more than others and have been close to, and have been closer to than others, but I've never actively disliked a teacher in my life.
I'd like to take this time to thank all my teachers, Dr. Hall. I'd like to thank all my friends and acquaintances for making high school pretty cool, a pretty awesome experience.
I think that my teachers at Brighton really helped me to be more creative.
They provide us with a lot of opportunities that we've been able to capitalize on throughout our time at high school.
Yeah, I honestly can't picture myself going anywhere but here. Your teachers are so amazing.
I appreciate all my teachers that took time and put in work with me, man. We officially signing out on this day. And I appreciate and thank every last one of these teachers that took time to help me out.
Thanks to all the teachers and all the staff around the school, we appreciate everything you guys have done over the last 4 years.
Yeah, staff's amazing, you know, teacher's amazing. That's all I have to say.
I'd like to thank every teacher that I've had because they really taught me how to be myself.
The teachers have been really amazing this year, especially during the pandemic. They were super patient and flexible, and I just appreciate that so much. My school year wouldn't be the same without them.
Thank you so much to all the teachers who helped us so much these past 4 years.
I have like countless of fun memories with them, and they're like beyond teachers too. Like, I'm like friends with like all my teachers, and not in a weird way, but
I love you all.
Thank you, teacher.
For allowing me to goof off in all of your classes.
Yeah, you're caring about your students.
I care about
your
students.
What they said.
Thank you, teachers.
Thank you, teachers. My experience is awesome.
Thanks, teachers.
That was incredible, and thanks to Eric Ruhner too. Can you join me in thanking Eric for capturing that? I'd like to also point out, in terms of the thanks, how incredibly lucky we are also to work in a community that is so supportive. Don't get me wrong, I know in large part that has to do with your work and the trust that they have in you. But in a world where people who previously said they did not understand their child's math homework became epidemiologists and experts in public health, they were always incredibly supportive of what you were doing. And we were largely supported by a very reasonable, rational, thoughtful community where people have looked out for each other and for all of you. And it doesn't take long to scroll through Facebook or see things on the local news to recognize that that's not happening everywhere. And we're lucky to be in the place that we are. So it's a great time to be a Bruin. In fact, I'd argue that it has never been a better time to be a Bruin, which brings me to this year and building on your success. Take a second to look at these numbers behind me. It's really unbelievable. And this is a K through 12 effort. This starts in kindergarten. It helps to have support from home, but it is every one of you that makes this happen. Our graduation rate was 86% in 2013. It's now 97% for all students, every student that walks in the building. It was 72% for Hispanic students, and it is now 93%. 54% for African American students, now 92%. 72% for economically disadvantaged students, now 95%. The reality is, the fact that there's very little or no statistical gap between groups is what is also incredibly remarkable. 97% is amazing, but the fact that that's for all kids is a tribute to each and every one of you, living every child, every day, every way, not just saying it. Do you also know that 77% of our students leave BHS having taken at least one AP course? 77% of our kids. So for those of you not at the high school level, think about nearly 8 in 10 kids in your class will leave having taken at least one AP class. That's pretty amazing. And that's up 6% from just 2 years ago. The greatest growth in representation in those courses is among multiracial students from 33% to 88% last year, and African American students from 22% to 48%. So this is for all kids, and that's very, very important to point out as well. So again, you're not just saying every child, every day, every way. You are living it. Know that that's so appreciated. You haven't lowered your expectations for that to happen either. I think that's really important to point out. You have not lowered your expectations. In fact, you've increased your expectation that all children will be successful. And then you've matched it with an ethic of care and support and a mindset that you will not rest until they meet that high expectation. You will not rest until they meet that high expectation, paying attention to each individual child and getting them across the finish line. That's happening K through 12. That's happening because you're making it happen. And that deserves, again, a thanks to all of you. Congratulations on that. Nobody does that better. So let's keep it going. The district's blueprint, our plan for our work, and the document that guides us towards continuous improvement was updated this summer, as it is every year as well. I'm happy to say we're back and better, back and ready to crush it again in terms of this type of planning and the results that come from it. We focused on the priority areas that we had been working on pre-pandemic and developed very practical, very focused, clear action plans in every area. You're going to hear more about this later today in faculty meetings, department meetings, and throughout the year. But I just wanted to point out the three areas, the priorities that we're focused on. That's academic rigor for all students, systems that support our work, especially related to diversity, equity, and inclusion, and mental health and wellness. Those are really the three big buckets that we are most focused on at this point. In a broad sense, we'd like to encourage you to stay focused on challenging each and every child, supporting each and every child, being aware of and teaching to support mental health and wellness. And please continue to think and act inclusively and responsively to all students. It really boils down to that. Challenge, support, care. Challenge, support, care. Inclusively, responsively, and constantly. Within these lofty ideas, though, is nested two other important ideas that I'd like you to keep considering and reflecting on in your work. And the first idea is best considered by first taking in the thoughts of the 21st century philosopher and coach, Ted Lasso.
People saying there's something wrong with us. Not the way I see it. Okay, and here's why. I believe in communism. ROM communism, that is.
What is ROM communism?
Well, Bumbercatch, it is a worldview that reminds us that romantic comedies with folks like Tom Hanks, Meg Ryan, or Julia Roberts, and Hugh Grant, or who am I missing, Coach?
Drew Barrymore.
Mm-hmm.
So, Matthew McConaughey, obviously.
All right, yeah.
The Three Kates.
Yep. Beckinsale, Hudson, Winslet.
Yeah.
Forgot Blanchett.
Different spelling.
I enjoy Renee Zellweger and all the Bridget Jones movies. I mean, her accent is pitch perfect, and her gift for physical comedy is grossly underrated.
Word. Hell yeah, absolutely.
I saw Judy.
No, you gotta give it up for Zellweger. Look, point is, fellas, if all those attractive people, with their amazing apartments and interesting jobs, usually in some creative field, can go through some lighthearted struggles and still end up happy, then so can we.
Jennifer Lopez.
That's a great call, Danny, and not at all beat too late. Gentlemen, believing in ROM communism is all about believing that everything's going to work out in the end. Now, these next few months might be tricky, but that's just because we're going through our dark forest. Fairy tales do not start, nor do they end, in the dark forest. That son of a gun always shows up smack dab in the middle of a story. But it will all work out. Now, it may not work out how you think it will, or how you hope it does, but believe me, it will all work out. Exactly as it's supposed to. Our job is to have zero expectations and just let go.
Now you William.
All right, so if you could tell that my words today might be influenced by binging and being locked in the house for quite a while, perhaps, but I had to find a way to get Ted Lasso in there. I would not subscribe to that we have to have zero expectations. but this notion, though, that it will work out, and recognizing that kids are coming back in all different places, all different circumstances with all different needs, I think is something for us to keep thinking about. None of them are going to be entering the workforce and making a dramatic impact on the economy or raising their family very soon, not just yet at least. So I'd say take a breath, relax, it's okay, we have time, meet them where they are and where you are. Do not be stressed or pressured to make up for a pandemic in a matter of months. We have time, take it. ROM communism. It'll work out. We'll get there. And it's not that it's going to be easy or to take that lightly. There are all different needs walking in the door that we have to figure out. I just want you to know that it's okay. Take a breath. We'll get them there. They're coming in all different circumstances, and you're going to make it happen for them. But over time, it's not going to happen in the next month. It'll work out. So as Ted recommends also, because now I can't help it but to keep talking about Ted Lasso, be a goldfish, 10-second memory, happiest animal on earth. Let's move on from a crazy year, crazy circumstances, and simply be focused on what is right in front of us. Be a goldfish. We also need to keep thinking, I think, about making space for everyone and everyone's ideas. This is really a key concept, and I don't think our world has ever needed it more. We need to work really hard on finding balance, creating spaces where all kids and all perspectives are honored and are embraced. It's not to say that hateful or prejudiced or otherwise marginalizing perspectives are okay to be expressed. What I'm getting at is the idea that we need to create safe places and restore civil discourse in our community, making sure that we don't make it uncomfortable for dissenting opinions to be expressed. Frankly, if a child knows our politics, not our focus on other humans, but our politics, they're not able to freely express opinions that are different from ours. I'm not telling you can't ever express your politics. I'm just saying, think about this space that we're creating. We hold power over them in our relationships and should really do everything we possibly can to foster debate, critical thinking, support different perspectives, but through facts, relevant information, good research, and again, thoughtful dialogue, always creating a civil space for people to discuss their ideas freely. It's not happening other places. This is something I think we can do to make a really big impact in terms of the public discourse and as we shape and support leaders before they go off into their future. It doesn't mean not being vulnerable or sharing ideas, but rather creating a space for thoughtful and respectful discussion. Again, I don't think it's ever been more important. So my final share from this incredible philosopher around that idea and around all of this, frankly, is that change is hard. These things are all difficult. And as Ted says, taking on a challenge is a lot like riding a horse, isn't it? If you're comfortable while you're doing it, you're probably doing it wrong. It's not easy, it's not comfortable, and I want to recognize that too and thank you for that. So thanks for doing the uncomfortable and the challenging. You do it the right way every day for our kids. Frankly, my kids are so very fortunate for that. Your heart, your soul, your time, your perspective, and all that you are. I thank you for that and say welcome back to all of you. We're very blessed here at Brighton to work so collaboratively with an incredible Board of Education. These supportive leaders volunteer an unbelievable amount of time. They're always asking why not instead of why. How can we help more? What can we do? What can we do to support the staff, particularly over the last year and a half? It's always been part of their tradition, but it's been such a big part of the conversation. How are people and what can we do to help them? Is there anything that they need? Representing the Board of Education today and as a passionate advocate for this district, a Brighton grad, a community member, and a person who has taken the helm as president of our Board of Education, Larry Davis. Please welcome up to him.
Deep breath. Class of 81, by the way, thank you. Speaking for your entire school board, our most important message today is gratitude. Thank you for the challenges you have overcome in the last 18 months. Thank you for all that you have learned in the last 18 months and how you applied it to help our kids. Thank you for the problems you will continue to solve this year, many of which we will anticipate and a few of which we will not. You'll solve them anyways. Thank you. Special thank you to the Brighton facilities team who has worked tirelessly to continue to upgrade our learning spaces. Most importantly, thank you for challenging, listening, helping, and caring for this community's most important resources, the students. Have a great year.
Thank you so much, Larry. We work with the most incredible children that a community can offer. As you well know, you experience this each and every day. and I mentioned this morning as Luca got up and performed for us, that we also have the pleasure of welcoming another kind, bright, creative, and committed student who is a joy to know and work with. He's an excellent example of our incredible kids and here to welcome you back today. Please join me in welcoming BHS Executive Council President, Sofyan Syed.
Good morning, Brighton staff. My name is Sofyan Syed, and I'm a senior at the high school and the president of our executive council. I've been with the Brighton School District since first grade, so I've seen it all, from Council Rock to French Road to TCMS and now BHS. Growing up here has allowed me to not only build great relationships with my friends at school, but also administrators and people throughout our Brighton community. Teachers and counselors have been especially beneficial for me, as teachers always go the extra mile to help me before or after class, and counselors are ready to address my concerns regarding schoolwork, scheduling, or even my future beyond high school. As I reflect on my time in Brighton, I can only think of all the great opportunities made available to me. Being a part of various sports teams has allowed me to follow my love for basketball and football, and being parts of various clubs, such as the Muslim Student Association, helps promote an all-inclusive environment where students and teachers see each other eye to eye and everybody is respectful of each other's backgrounds, something that I love so much about Brighton. I would also like to take a minute on behalf of the student body to thank you, the Brighton staff, for sticking with us throughout the pandemic. It hasn't been easy for any of us, but with your support, we made it. I would also like to thank Dr. Hall and our superintendent, Dr. McGowan, for putting in tireless hours and helping us adapt to these changes. As we look forward to this coming year, we have so much to be excited about. Teachers, you don't have to sit on Zoom for hours and plan on asynchronous work. For us students, we can finally enjoy the traditional high school festivities once again. We are excited to dance at the pep rally, take a date to prom or ball, hear Mr. Wilson's sound effects, listen to Mr. Porta's crazy stories, and the list just keeps on going. More importantly, we will be able to see each other face to face, not just the A through L cohort or the M through Z cohort, but the entire student body. And that means so much to us. My time at Brighton has been so amazing, and I can't wait to see what this year has in store. Thank you.
Thank you, Sofyan. The Brighton Alumni Association is an excellent example of what makes this district like no other. Their accomplishments as individuals and collective commitment to their school is also unparalleled. Here to welcome you back from the Alumni Association is Mrs. Mary Jane Link. So Mary Jane would likely say to you this morning, I'm not sure where Mary Jane is, but in any case, I'm sure nobody will mind extra time at the end of this towards your morning. I would ask, though, in Mary Jane's tradition, anybody who is a Brighton alum, can you just put your hand up? Any of the staff members, Brighton alum? Pretty good number, and glad that you could continue the tradition and I could continue Mary Jane. And before Mary Jane, Pete French's tradition of asking for our staff members who are alum to put their hand up as they pass along the great traditions from when they were kids here, too. So thank you for that. We're very excited also to welcome an incredible group of new staff members to the district. It presents a great opportunity while we're together this morning or joining virtually to get to know them just a little bit. So let's meet our new staff members.
The Brighton Central School District team is ready for the start of the 2021-2022 season. Brighton has several new additions to their already strong team. Here's a look at those new staff members. For the Council Rock Primary School team, Bree Allen is a kindergarten teacher. Mrs. Allen previously taught third grade in West Irondequoit and Honeyoy Falls Lima Schools. Donald Benedict, a first grade teacher. He previously was a fifth grade teacher at Friends and a teacher in the Rochester City Schools. Madison Carter, a teaching assistant. She recently worked at 11th Hour Gifts in 12 Corners and previously tutored Rochester students from the refugee community. Patricia Castro Hughes is a kindergarten teacher. She previously worked as a teacher in Charlotte, North Carolina and in Rochester City Schools in a bilingual classroom. Anna Cohen is a kindergarten teacher, previously a special education teacher in Spencerport. Mateo Cunningworth is a kindergarten teacher, previously taught kindergarten and grades 1 through 3 at Rochester School No. 4. Jill Davis is a music teacher. She previously taught vocal music in Palmyra Macedon Schools. Audrey DiMatteo is an occupational therapist. She previously worked in other schools in the Rochester and Buffalo areas. Mark Engel is a kindergarten teacher. He previously taught third grade in Fredericksburg City Schools. Rachel Fairman is a teaching assistant. She previously was a performer at Disney, child care worker, and camp counselor. Shirley Flores is the assistant principal. She previously was the elementary school principal at Eugenio Maria de Hostas Charter School in Rochester. Molly Glanville, a kindergarten teacher, recently taught reading and grades K-2 in Wayland, Cohocton, and Victor Schools. Patricia Goenginger is a teaching assistant. She has previous experience in special education. Antonia Henninger is a teaching assistant. She previously worked in research administration and management and is pursuing her teaching assistant certificate. Karen Huber is a school nurse. She previously served as an RN at Mary Cariola Children's Center and CP Rochester and Strong Behavioral Health's Child and Adolescent Outpatient Clinic. Max Krieger is a physical education teacher. He previously taught physical education at Monroe No. 1 BOCES and a boarding school in Long Island. Deepi Keza is a teaching assistant. She previously worked in clerical and executive positions in the banking and medical fields. Luz Mendez is a cleaner. She previously worked in a nursing home. Robin Murray is a teaching assistant, previously a substitute teacher in Brighton and taught in Oregon and Baltimore. Maria Otero Rizoy is a food service helper. She previously worked in childcare at the Rochester Athletic Club for Women. Emily Petrelli is a teaching assistant. She previously worked at a daycare and at summer camps. Ben Rivers is a cleaner. He's a 2021 graduate of Brighton High School. Rebecca Rizzo, a first grade teacher, previously was a grade 1 through 6 teacher, reading teacher, and intervention teacher in Rochester Schools. Francesca Cerace is a special education teacher. She previously was a classroom and student aide at Monroe No. 2 BOCES. Casey White is a teaching assistant. She previously taught art at Catholic schools and at preschool. Hector Yangus is a security guard. He is a retired NYPD officer. For the Council Rock Primary School and French Road Elementary School teams, Danielle Edmonds. She's the instructional technology integration specialist. She spent the last 2 years working as an assistant principal at Dansville High School and previously worked in Brighton as the digital innovations coach, English teacher, and Brighton Teacher Center director. For the French Road Elementary School team, Kelsey Brewer. She's a third grade special education teacher. She previously worked at the Bird Morgan School. Peter Early is a teacher aide. He previously was a lead teacher at a daycare and a contact tracer. Lydia Kiner is a primary project child associate. She previously was a part-time teaching assistant at Council Rock and was a dance instructor at Rock Dance in Webster. Meg McSweeney is a fourth grade teacher. She was previously a fourth grade teacher in Avon. Leslie Muhammad is a fifth grade teacher. She previously worked at Discovery Charter School. Matthew Ohm, a special education teacher. He previously taught special education at the Center for Discovery. Corey Peels is a food service helper. She worked part-time at Fres the last 2 years. Richard Blumary is a security guard. He previously did security for the Monroe County Parks Department. Catherine Whitman is a teaching assistant. She previously was a teacher aide in East Irondequoit Schools. Rachel Ziger is a special education teacher. She previously taught in Penfield and Victor Schools. For the French Road Elementary School and 12 Corners Middle School teams, Cedric Goodwill. He's a physical education teacher. He previously taught at the Academy of Health Sciences Charter School in Rochester. For the French Road Elementary School and Brighton High School teams, Lindsay Licenzio. She's a speech-language pathologist. Previously was a speech-language pathologist at Discovery Charter School. For the 12 Corners Middle School team, Emily Carazzi. She is a math teacher, previously was a clinical assistant at Northeast College Prep in Rochester. Jenna Clark is a teaching assistant. She previously was employed as a patient care coordinator at Limitless Physical Therapy and as an assistant softball coach at Monroe Community College. Bethany Cripps is an instrumental music teacher. She previously taught middle school music in Liverpool. Rick Kanabrowski is a health teacher. He previously worked as a health teacher in Rochester schools. Susan Thomas Payne is a teaching assistant. She previously was the recreation director at Heather Heights in Pittsburgh. Carlos Santos is a cleaner. He previously worked for a company that cleaned commercial properties. Jared White is a general music teacher. He student taught at BHS and TCMS last spring. Lauren White is a cook manager. She previously was a cook manager in Penfield. Meredith Williamson is a special education teacher. She previously taught in Geneva, Greece, and Fairport schools. For the 12 Corners Middle School and Brighton High School teams, Angela Dana. She's a 6-12 literacy intervention specialist. She previously worked at Canandaigua Middle School and Canandaigua Elementary School as a reading teacher. Corey Solano, a Spanish teacher. She previously taught in Wayne, Geneva Schools, and Eugenio Maria de Hostas Charter School in Rochester. At Brighton High School, Khadija Weiss is a food service helper. She has been a sub-food service helper for 2 years. Chris Cameron is a cook manager. He previously worked in food service management at the University of Rochester. Jeremy Carrastillo is a teaching assistant. He previously was a surveyor at Barry J. Carrastillo Surveying. Ruth Delgado is an administrative assistant to the assistant principals. She previously was a paralegal for a criminal defense firm in Rochester. Ashley Edwards is an assistant principal. She previously was an assistant principal at Fairport High School. Emily Froelich is a school nurse. She previously was a nurse for Rochester Regional Health and Strong Memorial Hospital. Bradley Hurst is a security guard. He previously did security for Rochester City Schools. James Wynn is a math teacher. He previously was a substitute teacher in area schools. Jamie Osborne is a teaching assistant. She previously was a teaching assistant in Hilton. Keegan Plain is a special education teacher. She previously taught at Genesee Valley BOCES. Barry Rogenmoser is an English teacher. He previously taught English at Mid Lakes High School. Corey Wright is a business teacher. Previously taught business at Monroe No. 1 BOCES. And those are your new additions to the Brighton Central School District team.
Time for the talent portion of the introductions if they want to come on. No, I'm just kidding. Of course not. I felt like that was Bulls are back in the finals. Eric, thank you for the music and the introductions. It was really fantastic. Just a brief housekeeping reminder and a couple of more thank yous as we wrap up as well. I don't believe any other superintendent can say at this point every year and really mean it from the heart the way I do that the collective relationship that we have as a team is very, very special. It's very important to me, and the relationship we have collectively with each of the bargaining units is incredibly important, and it is vibrant, and it is what makes us who we are. We're grateful for the ability to work collaboratively, warmly, and in a manner that balances well the needs of our staff with our mutual goals of being professionals focused on students. We enjoy a very meaningful and collaborative relationship with all non-unit staff members as well, bargaining units representing paraprofessionals, tutors, clerical staff, technology staff, building and ground staff members, nurses, and administrators. And what could be a formal business relationship is much more than that. These are collaborative partnerships on behalf of great professionals who seek to do the best that they can for children. Jamie Porter, the new BTA president, and a colleague I've had the pleasure of already working with and appreciating, has asked that I remind all of you that there's a general meeting of the BTA to take place right here immediately following this meeting. And Cheryl Becker, president of the Brighton Education Paraprofessionals Association, another friend and colleague whose work is so appreciated, has also asked that I remind all those unit members that they will have a meeting right here at BHS in the lower level of the library, also immediately following this meeting. As I have had the pleasure and honor of saying to you on 13 opening days now, children are so much better for having spent their days with you. You are the magic makers and the dream catchers. The world and all of us in it will be better off because of all that you do for children. You are heroes in this world and for our children. It will be another great year, and it will be that because of you. You are Brighton, you are excellence for all children. Thank you, good luck, and best wishes for your best year yet. Thank you.
This has been a special presentation from the Brighton Central School District.